we have been reporting, there are new health concerns tonight about kindergartners. National data now reveals a record high rate received exemptions last year from getting vaccines required for school. Here to explain is Dr. Scott Hadland, Chief of Adolescent and Young Adult Medicine at Mass General for Children. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for having me.
All right, Dr. Hadland, let's talk first about these exemptions. So what is available vis-a-vis exemptions here in Massachusetts, if anything?
Right. Well, Massachusetts, like other states in this country, requires that kindergarten students, when they enter, be vaccinated against certain core illnesses that are preventable. This includes things like diphtheria and tetanus and pertussis and polio. And there are allowances for two types of exemptions here in Massachusetts. The first one, which is less common, is a medical exemption. This is the idea that a child shouldn't receive a vaccine because it could put them at risk. So, for example, you know, a child who may have cancer and maybe undergoing chemotherapy and may have an immune system that's compromised, leaving them not suitable to receive a vaccine. That's the first type of exemption, and it's much less common. The second type of exemption, and the one that seems to be on the rise across the country right now, are religious exemptions or non-medical exemptions. The idea that, you know, a family has a particular belief that runs contrary to their child receiving a vaccination, and therefore their child doesn't receive it before starting kindergarten. We do allow this here in Massachusetts.
Okay, well, we know some parents, especially in other states, not Massachusetts, have been reluctant to vaccinate their children against COVID. So do you think that's a factor here?
I do think it's a factor here. And you know, to put this into context, most young people are vaccinated. So here in Massachusetts, you know, the number of students that have these exemptions is really only about 1 in 70, which means that the vast majority of young people in schools, and I see this in my own practice, you know, come from families that want their children to be protected, want them to get these vaccinations. But you're right, you know, COVID and the vaccine that we developed for it, although we had strong data to show that it was safe and effective, it was new for many people. And some people, you know, just didn't feel comfortable with a new vaccine. And this hesitancy, unfortunately, seems to have spilled over into other vaccine preventable illnesses, including, for example, polio, a devastating illness that can cause paralysis in children, and which we've had a vaccine for since the 1950s that is safe and has really sort of been a game changer in this country. We're now starting to see that some families are hesitant towards these vaccines that are safe and effective and been around for so long.
All right, so many of our viewers already know you're not just a doctor, you're also a dad with two young kids. So I want to ask you kind of a two-part question here about this skepticism online and in some neighborhoods about these certain vaccines. Number one, have you seen any reason yet to skip or delay any shots for your own kids? And number two, as a parent who I assume has vaccinated your kids, we have, it's pretty frustrating that other parents don't, right?
Right. Well, you know, so on the first point, yes, my children are fully vaccinated. They've been vaccinated on the recommended schedule without any delays. And I do this as a dad because I want to keep my kids safe and healthy and in school. And I also want to prevent other people in my life, in our lives, including, for example, my parents who are older and, you know, could be at risk if they were to acquire a vaccine preventable disease. I also want to highlight that, you know, to bring it back to me as a pediatrician, talk to pediatricians and they will tell you that they have cared for young people who have been affected by devastating vaccine preventable illnesses. The child who, you know, has been seriously ill or even died from flu. You know, I've cared for patients who have permanently lost their hearing from meningitis, which is vaccine preventable. And so, you know, I reserve my frustration. I don't feel frustrated. I want to just encourage folks to go out, talk to their doctors, talk to their healthcare providers, and if they are having concerns or hesitancy, to ask questions because we're here to help with this.
Dr. Scott Hadland, thanks as always for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.